You don't have the right to call me. Okay? Bye-bye.
So you asked me to...
Back in 2012, I received an email from the so-called barrister Kofi Mensah, who claimed to represent a client with a large sum of money from a gold deal that had gone wrong. If I would launder the millions through my bank account, I could keep 40% of the money. However, I would have to send Barrister Mensah a fee of £1,500 to pay for some documents from the High Court in order to release my millions. So off I went to the money transfer outlets. This was originally my first upload on YouTube. I removed it a few years ago due to very poor audio. By popular request, here it is back again, remastered and with some new material. Enjoy.
Hello?
Hello, Kofi Mensah, please.
Yes, how are you?
Sir, my name is Mr. Pricky. I'm ringing from England.
Yes.
Sir, you've sent me a number of emails, and I'm trying to send the money.
Okay. Do you have the name to send it to?
Yes, I have that. Thank you. Right, it's £1,500, sir. I'm at the office now. I have the cash with me. I'm going to go and pay it, but I need you to wait there so I can get you the payment number.
Okay.
I'll call you back.
Okay, thank you.
Bye-bye.
Hello?
Mr. Mensah?
Yes.
Sir, it's Mr. Pricky again.
Yes.
I have paid the money, £1,500.
Yes.
The clerk has taken the money into the office and he's going to ring you. He wants to speak with you to check that I'm not money laundering.
Okay.
He's going to ring you now on his phone. So if you hang up, he will ring you now.
Okay,
bye-bye.
Bye. Hello? Yeah.
This is Fahad.
Okay.
Can I speak to Mr. Kofi Mensah?
Yeah, speak.
I have £1,500 paid by Mr. Pricky to be sent to you. Is that right?
Right.
Can I ask you a few questions about this money, please?
Yeah, you can ask me any question you want to ask me.
Okay. Why is he sending you this amount of money?
Yeah, it is to help his son here in Ghana. He has a son here in Ghana.
Okay, so it's not money laundering?
No, not money laundering.
Oh, there's nothing illegal about it?
No, it's not money laundering, okay?
Okay, I'm going to release the money, but I need to ask you something very important.
Yes, go on.
I know you are a 419 scammer, okay? And you have the choice either to tell Mr. Pricky about this and he can withdraw his money, or I can send you part of the money.
You said what? You will send me part of the money?
Yes, because I know you are a scammer and I need
Listen, my friend, let me tell you something. I'm not a scammer. Why are you saying this?
Well, I know
I'm
that.
I'm not a scammer. Listen, I have to tell you the fact too. I'm not a scammer, okay? If you think I'm a scammer, I can scan you my ID, then you take it to Ghana Embassy in UK for confirmation.
Maybe it's stolen identity. I will not be 100% sure.
No, I cannot steal identity. I don't understand what you are talking about.
Mr. Kofi, you need to understand my situation. I have a family, so I need the money, my friend.
You are very funny.
No, this is the fact. If you don't comply with me, I'm gonna block this transfer and I'm gonna give him back his money. I will tell him that you're a scammer.
But listen, I'm not a scammer, and I can also tell him to go to Ghana Embassy to verify me. If you want to see me face to face in a webcam, I can bring my face out. Take it to Ghana Embassy. They know me every year. In Accra.
There is a solution. If you want, I can send you 10%. Is that okay?
You will send me 10%?
Yes, I will keep the 90%.
I don't understand what you are talking about. Instead of that, you give the money to him and you forget about the business. His son is here. You have to talk with his son.
Mr. Kofi, either you comply with me.
Listen, you can tell him anything you want to tell him. That is not my business. Because I know what I'm doing is genuine. So, how can I comply with you? Okay, if you send me the 10% and I gave the 10% to the son, then the son will tell him that I gave him 10%. What? Well, I don't understand.
I will increase it to 20%. This is the best I can do.
Listen, my friend. You know what? I don't know what to tell you anyway, but I'm not interested on that. You tell him to keep his money, okay?
Excellent.
Tell him to keep his money, okay?
Okay.
Tell him to keep his money. I'm not interested on that.
Okay.
How can you send me a 10% or 20% for what?
Okay, so either 20% or nothing.
Listen, I don't give a fuck. I know what I'm doing with Jenny. Okay, the money belongs to his son.
The last offer, I can give you 30%. I will keep 70.
Thank you, imagine. In fact, I told you, you give him the money back. That is all. Tell him to take his money back. That is okay by me.
I will tell him that you are a dirty scammer. Is that okay?
Listen, if you tell him that I'm a scammer, no problem. But let him take his money back. I will talk to him later. Okay?
Okay, yeah. Talk to him later. Bye-bye. They have this ego. I mean, it's 30% or nothing. No, no. Give him his money back. Greedy.
Hello?
Barrister Mensah, this is Pricky again.
Yes.
So I don't understand what went on. The man has given me the money back.
I told him to give you the money back because I don't understand what the man is talking about. So you have to owe your money back. That is all.
Sir, there's a money transfer office over the road. Shall I go there?
Okay, you can do that. Okay.
Wait there, I'll ring you back.
Okay. Hello?
Hello?
Yeah?
Is this Mr. Kofi Mensah?
Yes.
The customer came in, Mr. Pricky Queerhouse. He wants to send you £1,500?
Yes.
Yeah, this is about the transaction that Mr. Pricky wants to send you the money. I have a few questions for you.
Yes, go on with your question.
Yeah, I need to confirm this is not for money laundering. So, what exactly is the purpose of the money?
It's for his son. Upkeeping of his son.
Can you explain, please?
He has a son, yeah.
You have
a
son?
In Accra. He has a son, yeah. He has a son, yeah. He's going to take care of his son. Okay?
No, I don't understand. Can you explain, please? Slowly.
You said?
Can you explain to me slowly what the money is for, please?
I said it's for his son. Upkeeping of his son.
Whose son?
I said it's for his son, okay?
I do not understand. Can you
explain? Listen, you give him before. Let me talk to him. I don't understand this, okay?
Listen, please.
Listen, let me tell you something. I don't understand this. If you know he wants to send the money, you send the money. I don't give a fuck about this. Why are you asking me a question?
Listen. It is
listen
the office,
to me.
It is the office policy that I ask about transfers. Do you understand?
Listen. Let me tell you something. Let me talk to him. Let me talk to him, please. I have to talk to him.
Wait, listen to me. He's outside my office right now.
I said I want to talk to him. You call him. You tell him to call me. Let me talk to him. Okay?
Please do not shout.
Let me talk to him.
All I want to know is what is the money for?
Listen, let me talk to him. I have to talk to him. Please.
I will let you talk to him. Wait. Give me 1 second. Just tell me what the money is for. If you can explain, I will
listen,
transfer.
Listen, I said the money is for upkeeping. Upkeeping.
Upkeeping of what?
Of his son. Of his son. He has a son, yeah. He has children, yeah. Don't you know that?
He has a son there?
My friend, listen to me. Tell him to call me. I'm so surprised when you people are calling me. I don't understand. If you want to send the money, let him send the money. If you know you don't want him to use your bank to send the money, then give him the money back. Give him the money back. That is okay.
I want to send you the money. Listen.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Give him the money back. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Wait. Am I sounding much?
Hello?
Barrister, it's Pricky again.
Yes?
Sir, I don't know what happened, but the man in the money transfer is very angry with me.
Listen, the office called me with the same number. So they are the same people talking to me. I know that. So that is why I said he should give you the money back. If you know you want to send the money, they don't supposed to call me and ask me questions. They're supposed to ask, what are you sending the money for? Then you have to tell them it's upkeeping of your children in Accra. That is all. They're not supposed to call me.
Yes, sir, they're brothers. It's two brothers.
Okay, if they are brothers, that's not my business. If you know you want to send this money, then you send the money. And you don't let anyone to call me. If they ask you, what are you sending the money for? You tell them, upkeeping your children in Ghana. That is all. If you know they don't want to send it, you wait tomorrow morning. You call me, then you send it there.
Sir, the man, he kept the money, he has it, and he's with me now. He's going to speak with you, he just wants to send the money to you now. So, get a pen and paper, sir. Here he is.
Mr. Mensah, listen.
Yes?
Yeah, I'm going to send you the money now.
Okay.
Okay, I trust you, I'm going to send you the money now, okay?
Okay, no problem.
I'm going to send you 10% of the 1,500 pounds.
Listen. I'm not doing that type of business. I'm not
listen,
doing that.
Listen.
Let me talk to him. Let me talk to him. I will take care of his sugar. Yeah. Give him back the money. Don't tell me that. Okay.
I will explain.
Bye bye. Give him back the money. Don't talk to me. Give him back the money.
This is too awesome.
I've got to get him back.
Give him the money.
Uh-huh.
Sir, this is Pricky again.
Listen to me carefully. Take the money back and go back home. When you get home, you call me. That is all.
He won't...
Listen, he said he wants to send 10% of the money, then he will owe 90% of the money. That is what he told me. And I don't do that type of transaction, you know? Take your money back. You don't worry about the money. Just take the money back. Okay?
Sir, he will only give me 10% back. He's kept 90% for himself.
No, you take all the money. Take all the money. All the money belongs to you. Don't worry about the money. Okay?
He won't give it to me. He has kept 30.
Listen, he has no right to all your money. Except you are playing game. Maybe you are playing game with him. I don't understand. He has no right to seize your money. Take your money back and go back home. Okay? That is okay, don't send the money anymore. Take the money back and go back home. Don't send the money to me anymore. Okay? Thank you. Bye-bye. Hello?
It's Mr. Pricky.
Listen, let me tell you something. If you don't want to send the money, you forget about it. Well, you know, I have no right to call me. If you want to send the money, you tell them, they give you the form, you fill the form, you give them the money, then they send the money, then you give me the control number, that is all. You don't have the right to call me, okay? If you know you don't want to send the money, then you forget about this transaction, okay? Bye-bye.
Sir, you asked me to...
Hello?
Barrister, how are you, my friend?
Who is this?
Mr. Pricky, how are you?
Please, don't call my line again. Don't call my line, okay?
Sir, I want to do business with you.
I don't want to do business with you.
Please, my old friend.
I said I don't want to do business with you, please. Don't call my line, okay?
How much money will I send you?
Don't send me money, please. I don't need your money.
I have the money.
I said I don't need your money.
Sir, I'm at it.
I don't need your money. Are you crazy, you piccolo? What did they do you? Sure, I said I don't want your money. You go cut the water in my life. Oh.
Sir, I'm at it.
I said I don't need your money. I don't want your money, please. I beg you with the name of God. I beg you with the name of God. I don't want your money. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Sir, I'm at it.
No, you go, not call my line again. Don't call my line again. Don't call my line again, okay?
Barrister, this is important. This is Miss.
Don't call my line again. Don't call my line again.